Hi guys, my name is Vivek and in this video I'll demonstrate how we can retain values from previous rows in Informatica. So our source table is the one that is shown above. So in this table you see that we have the sequence, employee ID and its corresponding role. So how the table is laid out, so first of all we have the manager and then we have certain employees that fall under him. For example, here we have A as the manager and B, C, D, E reports to A. Then we have F as manager and G, K, I, G reports to F. And then we have K as manager and L, M, N reports to K. Now we want a different type of structure in our target table where we want one-to-one direct relationship between employee ID and employee ID manager and employee ID employee. So that means it should directly demonstrate that B belongs to A, C belongs to A, or D reports to A, E reports to A, G reports to F, and so on. So there are various ways using which we can do this in Informatica. I'll be demonstrating one such way today here. So let's go ahead and create the mapping. I already have the source and the target tables. In the source table we have the data like this, and in the target table which we will be populating we will have data like this. So let me first quickly truncate the table, the target table, so that we can load it using our Informatica mapping. The table has been truncated. Now let's go ahead and create the mapping. So let me name it as m_demo value retention. Let's quickly get the source and target. So now what we need to do is we need to have an expression transformation where we will have all these values. The next step which I'm going to do is a very vital step. Now I'm going to use a variable port which will be variable manager employee ID and will be again string data type. So now understand this way. I'll run the mapping in debugger mode also to explain it more clearly, so don't worry. But yeah, so when the role is equals to manager, when the role is manager, what we will do is we will assign the employee ID value, otherwise we will retain the value of the variable. We'll see how it works. Let's see if the validation goes fine. And then we will create another output port which will be the output manager employee ID. This is an output port and we will assign it the variable value. Now one more thing, we have got the output manager employee ID. We don't need the sequence ID anymore, so I'll keep it as input port only. Let's go ahead and let's add a filter transformation. I'll explain why the filter transformation is required in the debugger mode. So here I'm going to, if role is equals to manager, I'm going to filter that row. And I'll map my two employee ID. So let's get an understanding of what we have done till now. We had created a variable port where if the role is equals to manager, then we are assigning it the employee ID, Otherwise, we are assigning it the previous value. So let's see how this will work in the debugger mode. That's the best way to understand this. So the session has been created and the workflow has been created. Let me run it in debugger mode. The first value from the source qualifier, the sequence ID is 1, the employee ID is A, and the role is manager. Okay, let's go ahead. In the expression transformation, we had assigned the value of variable manager, that if the role is equals to manager, assign the value A to the variable. That means assign the employee ID to the variable and the output will be assigned this variable value. So we got A here. Now let's go ahead. In the filter transformation, I have specified if role is equals to manager, then filter the row. So the row will be filtered. It seems something got messed up in the filter condition. Let's quickly clean that condition before we run it again. I should have specified where role not equals to manager. I'll explain that why. So let's go back, start the debugger. So you see the first value is 1, A and manager. In the expression, the variable manager employee ID was assigned as A and the output manager ID is also A. In the filter transformation, the row got filtered because the row was manager. Now comes the crucial part. The second row is B and the role is employee. Okay, let's move ahead. If you see, here we have the previous manager ID restored, because if you remember the condition, we were assigning it the new value only if the role was manager, otherwise the previous value was retained. Okay, so let's go ahead. Here the row will not be filtered because the role is equals to employee. That means the employee ID manager A is inserted and the employee ID of employee is B. That row will be inserted. Let's go ahead. We have another employee. So this employee should be inserted and the manager ID should be A. So it got inserted. Now for the next employee, again it's an employee. So it should get inserted. Now it's again an employee E. So it should get inserted with manager A. Now the manager has changed. Now this is another critical part. So remember, when the role name is equals to manager, then the value of that variable should be reassigned. So the value is reassigned and the row has been filtered. Okay, so now its corresponding employee will come under it and so on. So that means our mapping logic is working correctly. So the only thing that we need to take care in such cases is the value that we are assigning to the variable should be retained according to our logic. Okay, so let's do one thing. Let's shut down the debugger quickly and run the workflow. The name of the workflow was workflow M demo value retention. Let's run it. It has succeeded. Let's see if it loaded the results correctly. So the results have been loaded correctly. If you see, we have the manager for employees B, C, D and E. We got the correct manager A. For G, H, I, J, we got the correct manager as F. And for L, M, N, we got the manager as K. So the purpose that was required has been resolved now. There can be other approaches as well that can be used to accomplish this task. But I think this one was more suitable and easy one. That's why I've used this in making this video. Thanks a lot for watching this video. For more such informative videos, please subscribe to my channel. And in case if you have any scenario on your mind that you want me to make a video on, please post in the comment section and I'll try to make a video on that scenario. Thanks a lot, guys.